back in class students. Hope everyone are fine, safe at home. Please do not trouble your parents. I hope in the last video whatever you have done, you have completed it. Let's have a recap. See, in the last class we have already done our exercise 3.2 addition. Right, grouping of additions, like when they have given two, simply when they have given a pair of numbers, we have added right in the column and then we have done the addition, right? So then what was the next? It was they have given three numbers. So first initially we have combined two numbers, then we have added. Like supposedly they have given 5 plus 3 plus 2. So what we have done? Initially, first two we have added, the number result we got, like 5 plus 3 is how much? 8, right? Now 8, that 2 we are going to add for 8. 8 plus 2 is. And this is how we have done grouping with two numbers. Simply we have that like zeros, right? This is what we have. We know additions like writing in columns. If they have given two numbers, 33. Then we have added, right? 45 plus 33 equals to how much? Then we have written in columns and we have added. When they have given three digits, we have grouped the first two digits. We have found the result that we have added. We have found the sum. To that sum, we have added the next digit, that is 2. So 8 plus 2, we get the result as 10. This is what we have done. So here, see in page number 121, they have given addition in real life. So even we follow addition in our real life. If we went to buy anything, right? If we went for shopping, so you will buy some pencil, your stationery, your box, your pencil, your books, all. What you will do when he asks amount, what you do? You will add how much for books, how much for pen, how much for pencil. You will add the total amount and you guess, then you will get guess. And you need to guess 70 rupees to the shopkeeper. Then how 70 rupees you got? You have added the amount of pencil, your exam pad, your books or whatever, right? All these things you have added. You came to know that I need to give 70 rupees. Then you have given the amount with the shopkeeper and you bought your or your stationery. The same way here in real life, what are the things we can in what are the things we can apply this addition? Okay, let's see here. Exercise 3.2. So today we are going to start exercise 3.2. So before starting, I request please everyone open your textbook page number 122 and open your classwork. Be ready and write the first question in your classwork. First question in your classwork. Yes. See what here they have given in page number 122, exercise 3.3. Read the following stories carefully and solve them. But now we need to read those questions and we are going to find the answer. Okay. So first one. They bought a TV for rupees 45,575 and a refrigerator for rupees 25,615. How much money did he spend it? All just when we have taken the example of a stationery where you have bought your pencil, eraser and you found, you have found it. You have firstly you have done the sum of those costs and you came to know identity. This identity. Same here, the here Dave, the boy Dave, he purchased a TV. Here a man Dave, he purchased TV for rupees around 45,475 and so it's 575. And refrigerator for rupees 25,615, right? He bought for TV. He bought TV for rupees 45,000 and refrigerator for around 25,000. Now how much amount he need? How much amount he has spending or means how much amount he has given? So what we do? We'll add these two values. Whatever the result, whatever the solution we get, that much amount he has spent to buy these two things. The same way, our example 70 rupees you have spent to buy your all stationery, right? Here the same way, they have given the values, what is how much, what is the cost of TV and the cost of refrigerator, we will find the total and that value, that answer is the amount he has spent in all. Okay, I hope it is very clear. Yes, very good. Now what you are going to do? Write date, write exercise 3.3. Write here, write your page number, write the first question. What's the first question? They bought a TV for rupees 45,575 and a refrigerator for rupees 25,650. How much money did he spend in all? This question you are going to write. For this, let us find the answer. Now, what are the given cost of TV and cost of refrigerator? Let us start. Cost of TV. Cost of television is what? It is rupees 45,575. 75. Cost of TV is 45,575. The same way, cost of refrigerator. Cost of refrigerator. What is the cost of refrigerator? Very good. Rupees 25,615 is the cost of refrigerator. Now, what we have given? That we have given. Cost of TV and cost of refrigerator. Now, what we need to find? How much money he is spending on? Yes, we already know that we have to do the addition. So what you are going to do, you are going to use your math problem. I think you can write it over here. Okay, let us write here. See, if you see the question, it says there are total 5 numbers over here. That is 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000. So better for vocabulary, let us write on the top. 1s, 10s, 100, 1000. 10,000. If you don't write, there is no problem, but for our convenience we can write this. So let us start. First is cost of TV is 45,575. Next we have to add this value to cost of refrigerator, that is 25,615. Now these two values we are going to add up. See, this question is right. 45,575 and 615. Yes. Now let us add these two values. 5 plus 5. 5 plus 5 is 10. Very good. Now what we will do? 1 will be carried forward over here in 10's place and 0 we are going to write here. Next. 7 plus 1. 8. 8 plus 1 is 9. 8 plus 1 is 9. 5 plus 6. Yes. What is 5 plus 6? 11. 5 plus 6 is 11. Now 1 again will be carried forward to the 1000's place and 1 we are going to write down. Again 5 plus 5 10. 10 plus 1 is 11. 10 plus 1 is 11. Now 4 plus 1 5. 5 plus 2 is 7. That is 70. Now if you put a comma, that is 71,190. So how much totally, how much money he has spent? 71,190 rupees. They spent it all. So what we will write last time? Therefore, they spent 71,190 in all. Means in total. In all is total. So how much money he has spent? 71,190 rupees he has spent in all who they has spent. Right? I hope you have written. So what we are going to do, see there are total 9 questions here, right? We have total 9 questions. So out of 9 we are going to go 5. Okay? So I will give you any 2 as homework. See, I'll explain you what is that. I'll give you the hint how you are going to solve that, and then you can easily do your homeworks, right? Okay. See, what is the second question? I hope you have written. Okay, let's go to the second question over here. A newspaper in this month, or the second month, you are going to do as your homework. I will give you a hint how you should solve. Okay. A newspaper agent delivers 15,545 English newspapers and 14,275 Hindi newspapers in a day. How many newspapers does he deliver in a day? Oh, I hope you have read this. Yes. So let me edit this first. So what we are saying here, a newspaper boy, a newspaper agent is delivering some English papers and some Hindi newspapers in a single day. So how many newspapers he is distributing, that value they have paid. So see, English newspapers are around 15,545. And how many Hindi newspapers? Hindi newspapers are 14,275. These are English newspapers and these are Hindi newspapers. So what we have to find, how many newspapers does he deliver in a day? So what we will say, how many newspapers does he deliver means we have to add these two values. happened, and number of interviews which were given is 14,475. Then you are going to find how many newspapers given in a day. It's total number of newspapers given in a day. You find the value that many newspapers have been delivered in a day. So what you are going to do for this question, you are going to add the both values. I hope it is very clear, and you are going to do this second one. Okay.
Next, 1000, 10,000.
10,000 then after this. So it's around 140,830 scooters have been manufactured in these 2 years. Is it clear? See, that what they asked, right? How many scooters did the factory manufacture in these 2 years? We found it is 140,830 scooters have been manufactured in these 2 years. 140,830 scooters. We need to write the last ending line. 140,830 scooters manufactured in these 2 years. Which are those 2 years? 2016 and 2017. Right? Yes. So this is first number of scooters manufactured in 2016, number of scooters manufactured in 2017, and total number of scooters manufactured in these 2 years. So this is also based on addition, right? So what is your homework for here? So today your homework is only one problem, that is second one. That also is based on addition. Simply you have to write the statements and then you are going to add up both the values. Okay, I already told how to write. So what's your homework today? Exercise 3.3, second question in your homework. Right, you are going to write in your classroom. Okay, I hope all these questions are very clear to you. So we will meet in the next class. Till then, take care. Bye.